Candles in Kosovo are lit this year, but not just for Christmas. An energy crisis has left homes without power and dimmed the lights in Pristina. Kosovo gets nearly half of its energy from abroad during the winter season. And the country's electricity distributor KEDS has announced electricity cuts, saying the cost of imports are now two steps to cover the winter's demand.
During the winter, people are using electricity for heating, so that is causing a lot of difficulties to find that energy. So we have to go to import, to stock exchange in the region, and we are buying at higher prices.
Kosovo has the region's cheapest electricity, but due to a breakdown of one of the country's two power plants, prices are expected to jump by about 30% in April. This has also doubled the demand for imports, and the government is already counting the losses.
The Kosovo government has allocated nearly $23 million to cover the import of energy. That's still a fair way off from what the country needs. And with no end in sight to the crisis, the government is now calling on the people to do their bit to save energy.
Kosovo still relies on coal-fired plants, which are about half a century old. And they disrupt more than just production.
Kosovo depends on this sector, on these obsolete power plants. Kosovo B is 40 years old, while Kosovo A is 60. In 2021, 34 employees died mainly from pollution, dust and poisonous gases, which we consider an occupational disease.
There are a few eco-generated power plants around the country, but not enough to replace coal.
We need to act very fast in the field of renewable energy projects, because same problem we might have during next year, for example. Because if Russian, for example, can stop the gas for European market, we will have the same problem. We need to be prepared in advance with adding of new capacity in solar energy, in wind power plants, maybe in some points with hydropower plants.
The government says it's now very close to drafting a roadmap to move the country to green energy by 2050. And the people in Kosovo hope it's more than just a shot in the dark. Haris Ademi, TRT World, Pristina, Kosovo.